Before seeing very interesting YouTube, let us see the following. In a recording before more than 40 years ago, Rabbi Liam Meirav says that he heard from the Kabbalist Rabbi Yitzhak Kadouri at the Yeshivat Ahavat Shalom in Jerusalem, that Rabbi Kadouri said that before the coming of the Messiah, they will not be able to form a government in Israel. By the way, one can hear this recording in the site in Hebrews, Kila Shem HaMlucha, or the kingdom is to God. Clearly can hear what Rabbi Merav Eliyahu Merav said, that he heard, and also he mentioned other, he didn't mention the name, but he says there are also other people who say these things. So let us see an amazing table which supports and confirms really this saying of Rabbi Kadouri. So what we see here, unbelievable. The first thing you can see, it is very significant. All comes in one book, Genesis, Aleph, yeah, which is said, we said many times that this program I use is Dr. Alexander Rothenberg, that he himself became Orthodox Jews, and he saw the phenomena of the course from Professor Rips, and he put the Torah letter after letter, and he did all this plan that I'm using. He did books together, he wrote also very important books, which is called All His Truths About the Courts. So let us see what you have here and how significant it is. So the first thing is in one book, Genesis. Now what I was looking for, did a while ago, not now. I was looking a while ago about the elections. In Hebrew is abchirot. You can see the word in red. Abchirot. The elections, and what we saw more unbelievable, Chozot, returning again and again, like we saw, Chozot, in the year, Beit Tavshin Pe Aleph, in this year, 5-7-81-2021. Then, when I look more, I saw, exactly what is going on. Atra'ah, warning. Yeah, it is, I think, the smallest script in the book of Genesis. Atra'ah is a warning. Now, which kind of warning? A warning that we hear from almost every day from Iran. Yeah, you can see Iran, who stress all the time to destroy Israel, to annihilate them. This is they believe, the Mehadi, the Imam, says clearly that all the time that Israel exists, their Mahdi cannot come. Amazing. So you have Iran, you have Yom threat and warning, really. Then, what is so interesting, looking more, in fact, even you have here the name of Abba Kadouri, Yitzhak Kadouri, Yitzhak Kadouri, unbelievable, yeah? But, as he said, as Rabbi Kadouri said more than 40 years ago, that this is a sign that you are before Messiah. We have to do tshuva. Unbelievable. You have here parallel the word repentance. Yeah? Not that it was simple to find the word tshuva exactly parallel to the elections. We're returning again and again, and you have also Messiah, you have Mashiach, and again Mashiach, maybe son of Joseph, maybe son of David, and even you have very small skip of Ben Ishai. So you have really such small, and you have repentance, you know, all this coming together is far away from being coincidence. Yeah, and the threats from Iran, you can hear. By the way, we have also very interesting, you have Yiramanai. Yeah, Hamanai. And Hamanai, as we said, you know, he's this one who's threatened all the time. Yeah, and he said that he's like the letter Haman, the same letter. And Haman, according to Rabbi Isaac Luria, our letter of strength, of power, Memnun, are part of the five Gvurot, which is called strength. And this is what he says, Rabbi Zachluria, because Jews transcend What Mordechai and Esther told them not to participate in this feast of Ahasuerus, they did not listen, and this came the decree of Haman, Holocaust, destruction, annihilation of the Jewish people. You know the story. Clearly, they were ready to do it, but at that time, the Jews listened to Mordechai and Esther. They did not make fun of them. It was a realize that they know what is going on. They fasted 3 days, praying to God, and everything turned over. We had Purim in the time of the Holocaust in Germany. When Rabbi said the same thing, yeah, I wrote a whole book, first of all, getting with Professor Aralik about Torah code, the Holocaust in Torah codes, and you can see many rabbis who said before that because of the reform, assimilation, transgressing of the Torah, Hitler will come, and it is so interesting. It is really known that one of the rabbis, Rabbi Salant, said to the reform, "You are doing now a new set of law in the Torah, changing the Torah. Come now, Hitler, Galvez, and they will make a new law against Jews." You know, this was brought to the Holocaust. So this is the difference in Purim. Jews listened to the rabbis, they knew that they know what is going on, they did Shuvah. And also they accepted, by the way, the oral Torah in Purim. In Sinai, they accepted only the written Torah. We saw what rabbis will tell us what to do. But when they saw the power of rabbis, definitely they accepted the Torah willingly. So it's amazing, right? So Amani, that's what the letter Aman. Today, same thing. I wrote a book, what's in a name, clearly bringing from our rabbis, Talmud, that God fixed names in the world that Jews will learn from, so with whom they are dealing. Yeah? Like Germania, Memnun, München, Memnun, Mengele, Memnun, Eichmann, Memnun, and tell us that all these forces are evil forces, not so strong. So here you have, as I said, that the election will come again, and will not be able to form government. And amazingly, we also bring in Netanyahu. Yeah, what it means that maybe he will be a prime minister, but meantime he's a prime minister. So it's altogether a very, very interesting table, very significant one, as I said, to have in one book, right? In one book, you have so clearly the warning from Iran, maybe, right? That the fact that the election, Abkhirot, Chozrot, all the time repeating again, is exactly the sign what Rabbi Kadouri said, his name also here, as we saw, that this is a sign that we are very near to the Messiah. No, what you have to do? We have to do Teshuvah, repentance. As Maimonides says, Israel will not be redeemed unless they are doing Shuvah. If not, God will force them to do Shuvah. They will have to do. Who knows if he is not in such a situation with such a threat, warning that, like in Six Day War, we know in Six Day War they expected half of Tel Aviv they made a cemetery. They expected a terrible disaster, but no, and miracles, you know the miracle in Shinsen. No, we hope that it will be the same now because Iran, you know, they will not change. Any agreement will not change because they are behaving according to what Allah says them, according to what the Imam says them. Yeah, and if they get a message, you have to wipe out Tel Aviv, Haifa, Israel, they will do it. Yeah? So all this agreement is nonsense. We know quite well because Iran acting according to what Mahdi tells them, you know, not according to what the government of Biden will tell them. It's an important, significant table. And look, as I said, very significant table to have in one book. And you have, as I said many times, Dr. Rosenberg, who made this program, he became Orthodox Jew, said clearly that the most important statistic is if it comes in one book, if it's a small skip, like warning, yeah? A warning should bring people to repent, to do tshuva, unbelievable, yeah? Yeah, best meeting. Then definitely also in one book, having this best meeting of Beit Tavshin Pe Aleph, Chod Bchirot Chozrot, election will return again. So, as I said, hoping that really we'll repent, we'll do Shuva, then we have Elijah will come, and Mashiach, son of Joseph, son of David, will appear there, yeah, and we'll have peace and quiet. And for Pesach, Passover is a time for Eliyahu to come. We're not quite there. The month Nisan that we're entering on very soon. Yeah, it's written that the month of Nisan, Jews were redeemed for Egypt and future will be redeemed also, right? So let us hope that really Jews will repent, will recognize that only God can save them, not the government, not Lapid, and not even Netanyahu, because they are in the hands of God. God can save us. Like in Purim, we just really did Shuva, return, and change all this terrible decree of Holocaust. Will be the same thing in Israel, because the threat of Holocaust is there. You know, the hundreds, thousand missiles we are directed to Israel, and it is only if the, you know, the Hamani will get some order from this, put a click on the button there, and all these hundreds of thousands missiles will be against Israel. Who knows? But we are now in really very serious situation. Yeah, people don't realize it. They have other problems. The problems. Netanyahu, Rak Lo Bibi, not Netanyahu, just leftists. But very important and significant table, this is what we look to us, because we know the Bible codes are part of the Torah. We know, we mentioned, you know, that Rabbi Bachya, you can see it in the Chumash, in the book on Genesis, chapter Aleph, about Ben Yisrael, about the moon and the sun, bring there the secret of the birth of the moon, yeah, which is indicated in 42 skip letters from Bereshit, the Bet to Hey Reish Dalet. Bet is Monday, Eid, Thursday, and Reish Dalet is 204 portions, because that time the hour was divided into 1080 parts, because it's the best number for divisions of numbers. You can see it's all in our site with Professor Robert Aralik, TorahCode.us. There you can find, see exactly the calculation to see clearly that according, the Jews knew more than 2,000 years ago that the birth, when the birth of the moon will be. The second, the clock, the atomic clock, which was used for it a while ago, shows almost the same, only what parts, small part of a second different. You can see everything is there in our set with Professor Aralik, TorahCode.us, also about the codes. What are the codes? This is one of the ways of studying Torah, learning Torah. The Rokeach on the Torah brings in the book of Bereshit. The Rokeach was about also a few hundred years ago from the Rishonim, and he says 73 ways of analyzing, learning Torah, and he brings there. He said 73 is the numerical value of Chokhmah, of wisdom, and he brings all these 73. Yeah, the abbreviation, first letter, last letter, full gematria, small gematria, everything he brings there, and one of them is codes, Bible, Torah code, amazing, so people should know it. It's not simple at all. And we see the great scientists like Dr. Rottenberg and Professor Michelson, yeah, was before in California University, in Russian, and then in Tel Aviv University, very famous one, he became clearly in a magazine, Mishpacha, he shows really, I mean, what brought him to become religious Jew. So he said, this is a cause, you know. And those Russian scientists, Michelson, Dr. Rosenberg, were all Russian rips. Yeah, no, it looked like the Russian have patience to look properly, yeah, and to realize the truth. But Israelis, you can see the professors, all kind of remarks, which is really Far from being scientific, as the one Wissung says, the opposition to courts is psychological, not scientific, because it was recognized by science to be science. It is known. Yeah? So why psychological? Because they don't want to accept that Torah is true, because they wouldn't be able to go to the Sion Shabbos, will not be able to go around on Shabbos and to sit in the coffee there, so they can sit outside, yeah, with the corona. So this is unfortunate situation. So very important and significant table in which you see so clearly what Rabbi Kadouri says. One can use the recording. He said, Rabbi Eliyahu Meir said clearly, I was in Yeshivat Rabbat Shalom, Jerusalem, the famous Yeshiva of Rabbi Hillel, really, Ken. And he heard this, he says, there are other people, yeah. And he himself, known to be his Baal Shuva, he was a big pilot in the army, yeah. Baal Shuva, okay, but very serious person. So let us follow this table probably, and now preparing ourselves for Pesach, for Nisan coming, and to do proper Shuva, and then you have peace and quiet, and really happiness and joy in the whole world.